neutral site action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Houston is lined up for the opening kickoff. So here we go. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Throws it in a hurry. He's pushed out of bounds, right around the 36-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
Slings it out there incomplete.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight. That makes
it second and 10. From their own 36-yard line, second down. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz coming.
And it's caught.
He faked out everybody in the stadium. When you can sell the run that well, you're going to have the upper hand on the defense.
Gets rid of it. That was incomplete, and it looked exactly like their last pass.
It was exact same play, and I think the offensive coordinator just tried to pull a fast one.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 40. Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way.
It looked like the pass was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular interception.
First and 10, ball on the 27. He steps out at the 32. That brings him second and 5. Plays good for about 6 yards and a first down.
That's a good call going with the draw there. It put just enough pause in the defense to allow a good game.
Throws and it's incomplete.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
From their own 38-yard line, second down. They hook up over the middle, and he's tackled around the 50-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And down he goes at the 35-yard line.
Man, did he ever sell the run? The defense took the bait, and that hesitation was enough to give the receiver room to make the catch.
Quick throw, and he's taken down around the 27-yard line. That makes it 7-2. He's taken down right around the 18-yard line. To that quickly. Touchdown, Cougars. And he hits the PAT. an 8-play, 72-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. So the score now, 7-0. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Cougars are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And they'll bring him down behind the line. Loss of two by the halfback. From their own 23-yard line, second down. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. And he hits him hard at the 43-yard line. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
Number 10, intended receiver on the play.
From their own 43-yard line, it's second down. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Tackle made around the 47-yard line. About 4 yards on that play.
You know, little passes like this force the defense to start to come up. Then you can see an offense take their chances downfield later to take advantage of the defense starting to cheat up.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. From the 39-yard line, it's second down. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a game of 7 on the play. Third down.
Throw, I don't think he got anything on that.
Why in the world would the offense run a route short for the first down? That just baffles me every time I see that.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. He's got an opening.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong, the offense is doing a nice job with first downs and they're executing well, but the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive, attack, do some things to change it up, take some risks.
That makes it first and goal.
His receiver, touchdown. That was a fine pass to get six.
Yep, he made a good decision and threw a very catchable ball.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. A 12-play, 76-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They got into the end zone last time. Let's see if they can match that on this possession.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Nice run up the middle. Fires that quickly, incomplete. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Gets it. He's in space. They'll bring him down at the 40-yard line. This flag came from the defensive secondary. Let's see what the call is. They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
From their own 21-yard line, third down. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
The ball just sailed on him, and he knows it. He'll get it next time.
Got the corner. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Quick throw out to the receiver. And they make the stop around the 20-yard line. Quick pass. Tackle at about the 11. Got an opening. Touchdown, Notre Dame. Tacks on the extra point. So a four-play, 29-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So our score, 14-7. Notre Dame is ready to kick it away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Caught, and he's brought down quickly. Well, if you like offense, you had to have loved that first quarter of play. The Fighting Irish lead, 14-7. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. They hand it off. Gets to about the 34-yard line. The 47-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Halfback's Got it on the quick throw. And he's tackled right around the 40. Strike to his receiver, no good.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. He makes his way to about the 32. He's at the 20. Makes it out to about the 16. Carries the ball for a nice game.
Gain of 7 yards.
Oh, yeah,
that'll make it 7-4.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Around the 2-yard line. They try to get a head start there.
False start. Offense.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
It's second and goal. 7 yards for the touchdown. Handoff, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. And he's taken down at about the 3-yard line. Fourth down, they're going to go for the easy three here. It's up, and he got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Notre Dame holds a 4-point lead. Quick out to his receiver. He's taken down at the 30. Taken down in the backfield. At the 43.
Number 50 makes the set at the 42-yard line.
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That makes it first and 10.
Here he goes. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Run work the outside. Pocket holds. Looks over the middle and it's picked off.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
They line up at the 14. First down. Made right around the 22-yard line. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Fires quick. He's got another one. They'll bring him down at about the 31. Pressure coming. Out to the receiver, and it's knocked away.
Number three was the intended receiver on the play.
That makes from their own 31-yard line. Second down. Fires it out. And they make the stop around the 49-yard line.
Getting him the ball in the passing game creates real havoc for the defense. There aren't many linebackers who can stay with him in coverage, that's for sure.
And a quick throw. Tackle right around the 36-yard line. He's able to break up the pass.
I know that the safety makes a good play here, but as a receiver, you got to get in there and play some defense. He's lucky that one wasn't intercepted.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. And here's a quick throw. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. It's the ninth play of the drive. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown.
Each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. It was an eight-play, 87-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow them down.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boy, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
An interception cut this offense last drive short, so I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Brought down at the 38-yard line.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
He's scrambling. That's a great tackle. That's the 49. Notre Dame's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
Yeah, let's go sack lunch.
First and 10. Ball on their own 49. And he's tackled at the 22-yard line. He gets rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
And he adds the extra point. Notre Dame yet set to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Scrambling around. Slides down.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 7-8.
Fires out to his receiver, and down he goes
at about the 39-yard line.
We've still got a half of football remaining. Notre Dame's up by 4.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. And he hits him hard at the 43-yard line. He airs it out. From their own 43-yard line, it's second down. And now the ball is loose. The defense scoops it, and he's taken down at the 49-yard line. And that fumble is going to cost him.
At this stage in the game, the number one rule has to be to hold on to the football.
quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Notre Dame is up four. He makes his way to about the 42.
That's a deep one. That brings up second and nine.
Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
Gain of 12 on the play. First down.
He makes his way to about the 22.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Here's an opening. Gains his way to the 10-yard line.
Gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and goal.
They bring him down in the backfield. And that run got stuffed.
Yeah, you're right. The defense definitely won the battle at the line of scrimmage there.
From the 14-yard line, second down. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. Get to that quickly. And he's leveled at the 12-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes us 30 more.
Here we go.
Got his receiver. Touchdown. We've got a change at the quarterback position. You've got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Got him in the screenplay. He's knocked out of bounds around the 36-yard line. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. And they lose a couple there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 34. Looks to him again, complete. He's taken down at about the 49.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
Complete, and he's out of bounds. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's tackled right around the 30.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again. The defense falls on it.
It's not like receivers don't practice hanging onto the ball all week. This is just a case of the defense creating a turnover.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Made the 39-yard line. 48-yard line. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed him.
From the 50, it's second down. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
That's a game 17.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home. Let's make these babies cry all the way back home. Let's go, Mike Kiki.
There's a strike complete. And they make the stop around the 15-yard line.
Number 24 brings his down at the 15-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
He's under pressure, steps up, and goes down.
That's a loss of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 9.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Tackle around the 22-yard line.
That's a team. Third down.
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. And he is drilled at the 15. It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. It's up, and it's through the uprights. Notre Dame kicked this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Fumble ended this offense's last drive. Let's see as they come out on the field what they'll do this time around.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Steps out of bounds right around the 28-yard line. Strike complete. He's down.
Number 6 makes the tackle at the 31-yard line.
Run.
That third and 2.
Ready. Run.
And he's tackled right away. Dropped it. So at the end of 3, Notre Dame leads it 31-17. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Down around the 40-yard line.
Number 6 makes the tackle at the 49.
And he's tackled right around the 18-yard line. Rifles it left, and it's intercepted.
He telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
20-yard line. First down. Got it and brought down immediately. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a good one. 4 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
He's at midfield. Gets out on the 45. Run up the middle.
That brings him second and five.
Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
That'll make it third and nine.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 35. Quick throw, and down he goes at about the 43-yard line. This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position in this football game. This one is a beauty. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. Now here comes the offense, and you've got to wonder if that last interception's weighing on the quarterback's mind at all.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. From their own 15-yard line. Second down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he's taken down around the 28-yard line. That'll push him over the 100-yard mark in receiving.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
Fires out to his wideout. He's taken down at the 38-yard line. He guns it to the right. It's intercepted. And they'll return this one all the way. He's tackled at the 50. He just jumped up and snatched that ball.
Well, there, I don't think the quarterback even saw him. The defender went up into the air and made a great catch.
Two minutes left in the ball game. He fights forward to about the 49. The halfback picks up a yard. Houston's going to take their first time out of the half. Yardage. The halfback just couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Loss of one.
And I'll tell you what, not only was this great penetration, but it was a heck of a hit, too.
Gets to about the 47-yard line. Well, they try to keep it on the ground for the first down.
You know, Brad, here the defense just steps up and makes a play, stopping them and bringing up fourth down.
He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Throws complete. He stopped immediately. And he stops the clock with a spike. It's third and five. Ball on the 25. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. He rifles it to the left. And it's caught. And they push him out around the 49-yard line.
When they broke the huddle, I'm sure everybody knew the ball was going to go to this receiver. And he still brought it in to give this team a big lift.
From their own 49-yard line, it's first down. Nearly intercepted.
Number 27 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
He's going to go for the home run. The offense looking here to exercise any red zone demons they might have after throwing an interception on their last trip. Just throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
In the shotgun and five wideouts. Throws and it's incomplete. And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Slings it. Tackle made around the 17-yard line. Under a minute left in the game. Scrambling around. Just an unbelievable stop where they had to have it on fourth down, and that should be the football game. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. He'll go down to one knee. Should do it. Our final tally in this one, 31-17, Fighting Irish. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.